Hello, beautiful people. It's Robin Thomas here with Reason With Me by Robin. Welcome back to my channel. So today is going to be a much quicker video than all of my recent uploads that I have been sharing with you all. So this one is just like a quick reminder for people who have allergic reactions or who have like sensitive skin to braiding hair or any type of hair that you're putting in or putting on your hair onto your scalp that is not yours, that gives you a breakout of some sort. So this is a reminder video that you can take steps to avoid that, or at least to prolong the your initial first wash day. So I had a client who was emailing me, and I have about every, I don't know, maybe twice a year or so, I encounter a client who would like for that service to be added. And so I added it a couple clients ago, you know, to be able to, because I provide the hair for box braids, to be able to wash the hair and cleanse the hair for them prior to their appointment. Because again, I provide it, and it's like, well, take this home, wash it, and bring it back. Like, no, I just go ahead and do it. So I do mine's a little different. I did used to start off using the ACV rinse. Like, it's pretty much known across. I actually even have a video, very old video, years ago, where I showed with crochet braids doing the ACV rinse for the crochet braid hair. But whenever I did have hair, I will always wash my braiding hair before and then continue like with my wash day and stuff like that. So I have changed up my routine a little bit, and it's really very simple. What I was doing initially was doing the ACV rinse first, then I was, because it stunk, I was going back and using shampoo and then conditioner. And so I just thought, well, if I shampoo the hair afterwards anyways, and I hear the squeaky cleanliness of it, then I might as well just go ahead and shampoo it as its cleanser, right? Because what you're trying to do is get that the alkaline film off of the braiding hair, the preservative, I guess, that they put on the braiding hair. So I say, well, I'm just going to use a super cleansing shampoo. So I opted for the Design Essentials Peppermint and Aloe shampoo. I know the name, like the actual title, is a little bit longer than that, but it was on there a couple seconds ago if you want to look at the whole thing. But yeah, so I just literally started to use regular shampoo instead of having so many steps, because this is, it's a lot dealing with the hair. It's not a lot, it's just, you know, it take longer than you would want it to, because you're washing like hair weave. You're not trying to get product built up out, but actually you are, because of the alkaline coating, which is ultimately build up on top of the hair. So you're trying to get it off. But I just was like, it shouldn't take me this long, you know what I'm saying, to wash all these bundles, and then I gotta go back because I don't like the smell. Even though you can let it air dry, and the smell would be like very, like, or be non-existent to very, very faint, like a very small smell. But for me, because I always would smell it, I would go back in like with conditioner, or again with another shampoo, then a conditioner to combat that. And I was like, I'm wasting time. So I just make sure to thoroughly go through and get the shampoo. You saw how I placed it on there. So get it everywhere with a cleansing shampoo. It doesn't lather as much. So making sure I get it all over the hair before I actually go in to start like shampooing and cleaning it. And then putting water all over so that I can get as much suds and I can activate it as much as I absolutely can. And then, yeah, I just, once I feel like I have it all the way in there, I go through and I simply rinse all of that out. Now, rinsing it out takes a long time, you know, because you want to make sure that it is 100% clear and clean, and you know, no residue is being left behind. You just don't want any of those problems when it comes to you trying to use your products and trying to put in the hair, or it's not or it starts to like mold or something like that because of the hair and it being wet and drying that way. Even though it's like, once it dries, it'll be fine. But you don't want to, you just don't want to worry about having any shampoo residue left over. All right, so once I get that first batch clear and clean or shampoo all out, I go in with the almond and avocado. Hopefully it'll show yourself. There it is, the almond and avocado. So this one is a moisturizing shampoo because I want to make sure that it is very much so thoroughly clean for my client and even, you know, for myself when I had hair. I want to make sure to get it clean, so I'll go back in with a second shampoo, and this time I do it with something a little bit more moisturizing. So not as, I'm running out of shampoo, so that's why you see me like pump. And I go through and I do the same thing, and I make sure it is nice and clean. So unlike the cleansing shampoo, this one does lather up on its own. As you see, I was pumping a lot, but it's because it's near the end there, so I really didn't have a lot of shampoo in my hand. This one lathers up a lot more, like a ton more than the cleansing shampoo. But yeah, so I like to go through to make sure again that it is thoroughly clean. Do not forget to open up that area, like, or open up the actual hair, because it's so thick and the hair or the fabric, because it's really not hair, but I mean we call it braiding hair, so the braiding hair is so thick that if you do not open that up, there is a possibility, like a very strong possibility, that you will not be cleaning the inside of that. Like, it's so thick that it could stay on the outside if you only had the shampoo on the outside and, you know, water the outside and wash it like that. So make sure that you are opening that up and getting that shampoo all in those strands. You see me going through again until it is squeaky clean. So honestly, that is my routine on how I clean the braiding hair for my clients. And, you know, if they do need it, I like to tell them, just to tell me in advance, because I like to air dry the hair. So I'll just leave it out to dry. I don't want to use a blow dryer, but I mean, if I absolutely have to, I will. Like, if something happens to where I'm just kind of behind on my schedule, but I do ask that I know ahead of time so that I can take the time out to wash it, you know, wash different bundles, especially depending on the hair, you know, if I have to do different colors, make sure that I have it nice and clean for my clients so that their install can start off itch free from the hair that's being added to them. So I'm gonna let you all continue to watch it. That's really all I do. If you have any questions, just leave them in the description, not the description box, just leave them in the comment section, and I'll be sure to answer your questions, any questions that you may have on this. Again, really simple, just get you a cleansing shampoo. If you only want to use one shampoo, make sure to do it at least two times to make sure that it is squeaky clean. And then make sure that your hair is 100% dry before you begin to install it onto your head. So yeah, that is all. I hope that this has helped you if you're having problems with that. If you're like, well, I just did my hair and I don't want to wash it, or I'm trying to prolong my wash day. Maybe you're having an allergic reaction to the actual braiding hair, and you need to take off that alkaline coating prior to installing it so that, you know, you won't have that allergic reaction. So yes, I hope that this has helped you all. I'm going to let you finish watching it, and I'll see you all next time. Peace and blessings.
Thank you.